We've got this very interesting book. I've had a lot of fun with this book. I've been messaging Fiona about it. I went to the charity shop to choose my next book, and I tend to like this kind of size, and it needs to be a hardback. And this one just talked to me, and it's called the, I don't know how you pronounce it, Debray's Etiquette and Modern Manners, Correct Behaviour for Every Sphere of Social and Business Life. And this book has been going on for a long, long time, over 200 years. And it has been regularly updated to reflect modern life and the appropriate etiquette. So I moved swiftly. I had this laugh with Fiona that I moved swiftly to courtship, to see exactly where Mark and I had gone wrong. And I was about two paragraphs in when I decided perhaps I ought to move to the divorce section. It's hilarious. Hilarious all the way through. It's not appropriate to dump one's partner by writing them a letter. And it is appropriate these days to allow one's partner to pay half of the meal. And whereas once upon a time it was deemed the only appropriate thing to do was to walk your date home to the door, that these days that's considered totally unnecessary, especially if you know you live in separate directions, so the gentleman is not expected to travel all the way to your front door, only to turn around and go all the way back again and then out to the home. So, but he should show due care to make sure that they get on the right train or in the right taxi, and some kind of message when they arrive home safe and sound to prove that they are caring. That's brilliant. I've learnt so much, and I'm going to be tearing pages out of it. And Fiona said that I've got to absorb it in case I get to meet the Queen one day, and then it'll be all there. But yeah, this book just totally drew itself to me, and so I thought that was quite fun. So I'm going to rip it apart. So I've had lots and lots of questions about how to initially prepare, what kind of book I use, is it a blank notebook, how do I initially go ahead and prepare for this. So I have got a page that I'm sort of working on as well, so it won't all be boring today. But as you can see, even though this book is not finished, it is getting quite bulky. It's not shutting, as I'm going to have to get some kind of latch, and it's no doubt going to go out further still. So that's the reason why we need to get rid of the papers, some of the papers. So before we get on to some of the more creative stuff, I'm going to show you, I'm going to move the camera down so that you can see I haven't done anything with this book at all. It's completely brand new how we go about starting to prepare this book. Okay, so we'll do some prep on it, and then we will move on to some more creative stuff. Okay, so I'm going to move the camera down so you don't have to look at me. So first thing I'm going to do is obviously take the paper cover off. I don't need that. When you go and buy a book, you need to make sure, and I was praying when I was looking, that this bit here is stitched, not glued. And this one was a little bit hard to see because it hasn't been read. Somebody has not taken care to learn their manners. It hasn't been read very much before it went swiftly down the junk shop. So I had to spend some time in the shop establishing whether it had signatures sewn in or whether it was glued, and you definitely want one with signatures. So when I had found signatures, I was like, what? So a signature basically is a section, and they often fall apart in the sections. I'm trying to find one. As I say, this was actually quite hard to, because it hasn't been used as a book So all that work. Right, so you can find, there we are. That'd be probably quite hard to see on camera, but there is the actual centre of the, this particular section has been stitched in. And so it's at each signature. You can see when you lift it up, that comes up together. It's at each signature. I pull out in the first instance, I'm just fairly gently pulling it out. One and two. Yeah, it is, it tends to be the older books, I think. So charity shop's definitely the way to go. So I'm taking out three pages to start with in that section. So the stitching will be slightly looser now. And so I need to go and find the next section. There it is. And I'm gonna do the same again. Now you don't have to do it all in one hit. You can do it as you work along, but often when you sort of prepare a few pages, obviously I've got some bedtime reading to do now with these pages I've ripped out. It's telling me how to behave at the altar, this one. Oh dear. So you are, by doing this systematically through the book in each section, you are allowing room for the 3D elements that you are putting into your journal, so that you hopefully don't get quite so much splaying out, so that you can actually kind of half shut the book. So you'll start to see bigger gaps when the book's shut. This is where you've taken pages out. So you know that that's where you can go work. So sometimes, and this is actually pretty good because, as I say, it's quite a new book. Not actually a new book, but not a used book. But sometimes you'll find that this section here in this seam, where it's been well read, is cracked and worn. And so what you do, hi Tanya, is, well, I use matte finish. You can use PVA, you can use Mod Podge, it's whatever you've got that is thoroughly get that area nice and juicy, and then shut the book. And that page will have stuck. And then we're gonna do the same again. Yep. Okay, shut the book. And I'm shutting the book rather than putting it up there to try to avoid the rumples and the creases. So all of that, this prep, is to keep the book strong as we work on it, because particularly the older books, the paper is often quite fragile. So I'm gonna do the same on the back. And this is gonna help strengthen it. Now, I will show you at when I'm a bit further down the road with my actual journal, the other journal, when it's wide, there is a way that we can expand the spine so that we can allow it to be thicker, if you like. But I don't need to do that just yet. And it depends on how much 3D stuff you put in. Okay. Hi Michelle, hi Jana. If you're sharing with me today, perhaps you could share some love and share it out for me. That would be really great. Oh, that hasn't stuck so well. This isn't as matte finish isn't as sticky. It does stick, but it isn't as sticky as PVA in as instantly gluey. So it needs a bit of time. Okay. So what you're doing is preserving the spine, making it stronger. All of this is sort of vital preparation. And even if you haven't got an idea of what you're going to do, you can sort of spend some days doing just preparation of pages. So I've done that. Now I'm going to just go back to where I've taken some pages out and show you what I do there. So three pages either side of the of that signature, the stitching is in there. I'm going to stick them together in exactly the same way as you've just seen me do. So this is going to make this page strong. This isn't the end of the prep, but it's the first stage. So, I'm covering up church preparations here. One should prepare for church. Blimey. And then stick in a third together as well. That's going to make a thick page one side of that stitching. It'll take a little while to dry. And then I'm going to do the same the other side of that stitching. And so on. So throughout the book, throughout the sections. Now, not all sections are going to be three pages thick, and I'll show you why in a minute. But as a rule of thumb, as a good starting place, three is pretty good. I'm just not enjoying my matte finish today. Gotta do it too quick. Sometimes I put it on both sides. It dries very quick, matte finish. Right, let's stick that together. Right, so that's my three pages that side, and started that one. Okay, and the three pages. Fantastic book. This is where I've gone wrong in life. I've got no manners, I've got no etiquette. I did not read this book. Right, so I've got two lots of three pages drying now. So they're in there, that's fine. I shall be able to find those at a later point. So that's basically the start of your book. You've got these. This is going to take some while. Back and front to protect your spine. And then you're going to take out sections and create your three pages either side of each section. So that's the starting point. Now, one of the things that I've done, and don't throw away these papers, you'll be able to use them for other things. So I'm bringing up my book back on. Now, I've been preparing this morning. And again, it still needs some drying time. But I'm going to create out of this back section. You notice it's upside down. That's because I've done the whole book upside down by mistake, but it doesn't matter. I'm going to cut out a hole. So I've created a wedge of paper and I've stuck them together and I've stuck them to the back and they're now drying. And I'm going to cut out a hole to put something in, secret hole. And then I have made a separate page with, I think there's two, maybe three here, and I've put paper on. I'm going to show you how to do that in just a sec. And that is, once I've cut the hole out and done what I want here, This is going to be on top, and then I will cut out a drawer, a door. Okay, so this will then all be glued down. So this page doesn't necessarily have to be as thick as a three pager. So just to show you how I've prepared this bit and this bit, we'll do the same in my book here. Okay, so we're going to go to the back and choose the depth of the hole that you want to make. So it could be quite a big one, doesn't matter if I go with that. Okay, now I'm going to use PVA for this because it's slightly thicker. I did use matte finish, could use Mod Podge. I haven't got Mod Podge, but I think this might be slightly more helpful. So this is just normal PVA. And I'm obviously gonna just coat my first one like so. And here, let's get some in here too. So this can be a bit messy. Okay, now I'm not gonna stick every single page together. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna shut the book so it's exactly as I'm going to want it down the edge there, can you see? And then I'm going to use the PVA glue to really get in there and seal that edge up. Okay, I'm going to do the same all along the top. I'm going to push it all together in a minute, but let's get this wet and gluey. So this isn't, you don't have to stick every page together because that's quite laborious. This is going to seal it. And down the side as well. Okay. So you can be quite generous with it. And if you happen to get splodged loads of it all over the front here, simply just add another page to it and that will protect it. That doesn't matter at all. So I'm now keep pushing it so this hasn't got a gap down it. And I'm going to use my PVA, is the same as Elmo's glue. It's just cheap children's, what you would have at school. And I'm just going to do the same here, just using these little clips. See, to keep that tight. And then you could use bulldog clips. I just haven't got any. I apologise, that's someone at the door. I think hubby might be home. Okay. So I'm just smoothing with my finger. Noodle. I'm just really smoothing that down. And then I'm going to shut the book and sit on it for a bit just to give some weight to it, okay? I'm literally going to sit on it. So if I can get it off my bum, raise the camera a little bit, okay. I'm going to be walking around with a book on my bum later. So this is a page I did a while ago that I didn't like, so I've gone ahead and I've covered it up and I'm going to do something new with it. So this is my dried area for me from earlier, and as you can see, some of it hasn't stuck and it's probably because I used matte finish. So I'm going to just touch that up. Give that some extra PVA. I'm going to want that to really dry, and then we will, that's what I shall be doing next week, is working on that pocket and the door. I just wanted to show you how to make it today. Okay. So just if it when you open it up, it's not solid, just add a bit more glue and we'll carry on from there. So I'll check it in the week. So once I've got my three, let's see if I've got another section of three pages stuck. I don't think I've got any. Yes, I have. These two are prepared and have stuck together and are quite solid. Okay, so I need to put something underneath this end so that you can, because now the book's getting a bit fat, it's hard to see. So what I do is I get a magazine, any magazine. Let me see if I can find one. I've got one under here, look. Just move that a minute. So I've just got an old magazine and I'm looking for a page which has got a fair bit of colour in it. So that's not bad, doesn't matter if it's got writing in it. I tear the page out and then I use a ruler to tear strips like that. Okay, it doesn't matter what colour, this is all going to be painted over, but I think it also just helps to give some texture and, I don't know, some energy. Okay. Of course, every layer that you do on this book, on this journal, is giving the page strength, and which is really important. You don't want a flimsy page. So again, you can use PVA, you can use Mod Podge, you can use matte finish, you can use whatever suits you, and you just enter it on the, stick it on the page. So if I prop it up a bit, hoping you can see that. And I create a layer. Now you could do it completely higgledy-piggledy, and there's no reason why you can't. It's just, I think it's my OCD that makes me want to do it up and down and back to front kind of thing. Okay. So I'm not at all worried about the writing being upside down. As I say, I'm creating strength in the page, some texture, and I'll show you how we're going to use this texture in a minute, because I've got another page prepared with it. So if you haven't already, I'd be really grateful if you could share it out somewhere you think might be interested. At the top of this live showing you the Fairy Chic Club, and there's all sorts of things going on in there. Please have a look. It is subscription, but the cheapest subscription is only £6 a month, and you get all sorts for that. If you're considering being a retailer of chalk paint, if you join my higher level, you get all of my chalk paint brand and everything that goes with it, 40% off. So, and there's no buy-in, no co- commitment that you have to make other than the monthly subscription. You can buy as much or as little as you like, as regularly, as often as you like. Already finding that quite a few members are finding that a really good way of working, because they can't commit to regular amounts, because obviously some months are always quieter than others, and to have to order when things are quiet and you haven't sold everything is just more stress. It's been quite a good way of working. Plus we do all sorts of tutorials on social media, workshops. I've got a workshop one coming up tomorrow. We have special guests in every month. We've had a fantastic one this month. We had Royce Bell. So I think you're getting the gist, okay? I'm gonna let that dry and finish that off afterwards. I think you get the gist. So I do all of that, and then now the chances are when I put these together that might well stick. It doesn't matter if I then later tear it apart and I've got some bits and fluff, that's just texture, that's fine, so don't worry too much about it. So I'm going to go to what I've prepared today. Now this was the page that I didn't like. You can vaguely see it through there. So what I'm going to do, and I've prepared a few pages, it will make sense hopefully once I get started. That's just a, and I've also prepared a separate page, and that's going to be stuck on there, and it will make sense once we get started. So what I've done is I've done the papers like you've already seen, and then I've done some raised stencil using a texture stencil that I can't see. I don't know what I did with that when I finished. Threw it somewhere probably. It's just a raised stencil anyway. And I use textured paste, which is a Fairy Chic product, and scraper to scrape through it. And I've allowed it to dry. It's because it was going to take time to dry that I had to do it ahead of time. And I've done the same on this page, and I've done some more on this fake page. Now this is some of the like inner books. This is how you can end up using it again, so don't throw it away. PVA is just another, it's St. Elmo's glue, I think is the American version, if that's what you use. So that's fine, just anything sticky. You can use tacky glue. I use all of them in different orders. Right, I'm going to use some today. I'm going to use initially a little bit of Jane Davenport distress crayons, color sticks they're called, and I've got two sets. I tend to stick to two or three colors for a page. So what am I going to do? I'm going to have a pink. Coming up to Valentine's, aren't we? And I think a green. Does that look a bit gary? I'll do the start. So these sticks are like crayons. You don't get a point. But you can use them in two ways. You can use them as I have here. Now this is what I mean about the lines that you've created, the texture from the paper that you've stuck on. So if I use this to accentuate them, and then I can use my finger and they smudge in. Okay. Now I can also use a paintbrush and they will turn into a paint. Yeah, my PVA is in a massive litre or 2 litre tub, and I just decanted it into a pot to make it more usable. Okay. I'm going to do the same on this page here. Now I could have gessoed over this page first, and I might still add some gesso later. It doesn't really matter what order you do these things, just the whole point is the playing, I think. But I'm using these strips of paper to guide me to create pattern on my page. Now I'm not worried about this page because this page is going to be covered up, but this page isn't because this page is going to be on top of it. So okay, so I have created an extra page to stick on this occasion, but if I had planned it ahead of time, I could have had a page, an additional page that was only too thick, but I didn't. So this has just been my way of getting around it. So you could do it in different ways. There's no right or wrong. See how rough I am being with this. And I'm going to use some water as well to get it to go over the raised stencil so that it will show. But I will get the majority of it on and blended as such. They are gorgeous. My whole journal is pretty bright, which I kind of like. There's some vintage elements in it. This is going to have some vintage elements in it too. But obviously, and you could have separate journals for different colour schemes, really, couldn't you? So. Right, I'm going to put a little bit of pink in. So it's a bit of a bizarre combination. But why not? And you can still see some of the paper and the writing underneath it. I quite like that. A lot to get through. Hope you've made a coffee. Okay. And you can see how utterly slapdash that was. So I'm now going to add a little bit of water to the pink because I'm not going to smudge that in. And you'll see the difference in what happens when you use water with it rather than your finger. It gives a more blended. Well, watery, I guess. Okay. Okay. nice looking page now. The same on here. I'm going to have to go with the dryer just very quickly to get that dried off. Right, so now to reveal what I'm going to be doing with this mystery page. Now I have got, now there's more stuff to go on this yet, but I'm going to put these away. I have got some Tim Holtz photographs. It's from one of those cardstock pads, and they are going to be going on here, and I've got another four children ones that are going to be going on this side. Okay, so I'm going to cut out a window here and then put some cellophane between the two so that you can see my pictures. So I'm going to move this to one side, and I'm going to use my my separate page to plan out my what I'm going to cut. Okay, so I've cut these all pretty roughly the same size. Okay, so I shall use them as my guide to draw a pencil line. And across this way. I should be able to work it out from there. And join that up. Okay, now we've also got windows, so I've got to do the lines in between. Okay, now with any luck, that should do me okay. So I just need to get my, crafting knife, which I thought I'd got out. Yeah. Oh look, the book has not stuck. So that's getting nice, that's nice and secure now. That was a good little tip there to sit on it for a bit. So I'll put that to one side. Right, so I'm going to use my crafting knife to cut through my windows. Just using the ruler very roughly. It would be fun to do a page today that doesn't involve actual art skills as such, because this is just fun. that anyone could do. A lot of my paintings, ones I do believe anyone can do, but not everyone believes me. So obviously this is a bit fiddly. I could have prepared this ahead of time, but I wanted to show you lots of, when I just do it and I tell you what I've done, people still keep messaging me, how have you done it, how have you done it? So I thought, well, I'll show you them. Hi Diane, you made it. Hope today's not too bad for you. Hi Joan. Oh, I haven't seen your name for a long time. If you've just joined, I'd be really grateful if you'd share this out for me. So, cutting my window. Relaxing, just messing around with ideas. Definitely messing around today. I've accidentally cut through that, but it will be fine because it's going to be glued. Okay, so I've got my page that's going to go there. So what I need to do is draw around those squares so I cut it out in exactly the right same place the other side. That's why I had to have a separate page. The cellophane is going to go between the two. Okay, so now I've got to cut out these squares this side, so I need to pop something in between to protect it. Here, this is like the Tim Holtz backing, so it's one of those card stocks that I've used for the photographs, the vintage photographs, but obviously you could use any. So I'm just going to cut the windows out freehand this side. Now, if any of you have just joined and you want to see how to prepare a journal from scratch, it's at the beginning of this live, and I go through it in quite detail for you guys. So, what kind of book to buy, how to prepare it, how to keep it strong, how to prepare your pages. So, just watch it on replay. see what I've got. Now you can keep these bits. I'm sure you'll be able to use them for tabs and so on. Tags in the future. This still feels a little, because I've only prepared this today, this page is a little bit wet. It is totally touch dry, but you can feel it's more floppy than it will be when it's overnight dried. Right, so that's brilliant. So before I go on to just stick the cellophane in place, I'm going to just stress up the page a bit. I'm just looking for my stamper. Oops, sorry about that. So I want to make sure that my edges of my frame. That's why I didn't do too much in the middle of this particular page, because I knew I was going to be cutting it out. So I'm using, this is Distress Oxide, and a smudger. You can use your fingers to smudge it about a bit. This is a kind of brown tea stain colour, and I'm going to put some darker colour on in a minute. Just, it helps, this helps show up the raised stenciling as well, I feel. It's like really pretty. So that's the brown. I'm going to use a bit of my, this is stone grey. It's not quite as harsh as black. I'll just try and put extra around the edges so it gives the whole picture within a picture a frame, if you like. Not bad. Okay, I'll do the same on this side. So my cellophane, you could use acetate, and I didn't have any, but this is literally, it's actually two pieces, and I'm going to use two just for strength. I think it was from an IOD bag or something, I don't think it matters. But I'm going to use, so I'm using a PVA glue, which for those of you in the US is St. Elmo's glue, I believe. Just gluing around the frame so that I can stick the cellophane down. Okay. Perfect. So, obviously, I want to try and smooth out each square so that there's not any rumples, but that's pretty good. Okay, now because it's a flap, this is two layers, I'm just going to put a second layer in here. Probably would have been alright with one. And then I can put my page that I've created on top of it. So I will glue around my page. Hi Susan. Raised stenciling is really effective, and it often doesn't start off looking effective. It's when you start adding the colours and then they're just stressed. I might even sand it back a bit as well, and then you start reveal some of the white from underneath. Okay. So this is my fake page. And I'm going upside down. So this might take, obviously it is relatively thick. It might take a little while to dry properly. And I might need to do some work on sealing that properly. So It might need some pressure on there. Isn't that cool? I've now got windows. Now I've cut out some of the Tim Holtz paper, and I'm going to distress it up. It up, and I'm going to stick it on my page. Oh no, you scream over all that beautiful. But yep, I'm going to do it. Let's cut the Jane Davenport coloured colour sticks, and they're fab. They like distress crayons, and you can rub them in with your fingers, or you can add water to them. There's two boxes, like that. They're about £20-25 a box, I will tell you. You can get them on Amazon, and I do think they're worth it. So I'm sticking one there. And I've got another one here under it. Again, stress it up. Okay, and we're gonna stick that one this side. Seems to be up the right way. Obviously the PVA will dry clear, so it doesn't really matter. I'm deliberately putting it at an angle, don't want it to look too uniformed. Okay, and my last thing is to get my pictures in play. So they are quite, I've just cut them out at the moment, and I think they need a bit of vintaging. I'm gonna try. Yeah, the brown works. Look at that. Like that. So I'm gonna just use my pad to help with that. Okay, so that's one. I did, he had some children ones. And some adult wedding ones. So I thought I'd do a children's page and a adults one. Oh no, they are lovely, so go enjoy. Yeah, Jane Davenport. In fact, when you get onto Amazon, you could lose a week of your life when you look up Jane Davenport. You kind of want everything. I kind of have everything because that happened to me. But no regrets, no regrets. Right, guys, I know we're hitting the hour, but I'm nearly there. I haven't got that much more to do, so hang on if you can. And then you get to see what all this effort was about. So I'm going to PVA these into the right place. So I need a bit of help with the window there. Okay, that one's there. I know we've gone past the hour. Oh no. But, you know, it's art. It takes as long as it takes. I don't think it even matters that that's a bit crookedy. I think it kind of adds to it. Okay. Last one that side. Down a bit. Perfect. Okay, so there's my four in place that side. Hope you can see that. That's very cool. Okay, and I didn't do any distressing around this frame. So I'm going to do it now. Try not to get it on cellophane. Still got work to do on that, gluing that down, but I will do that after. So I just need to get my four in this side, and today we'll be done. Where's my people? Mission for Jane Davenport because I keep using the stuff. Okay. I love it. How cool. How simple. So let's get this one in place first. This is all going to take a mammoth to dry. I'm working quite fresh with all this glue. There. There she is. Fabulous. Final bit of aging. Page isn't quite as yeah, one of the other things we're gonna do is go use this as an HB pencil. Just go around the frame. This is a really good way of framing edges. If you go in with a soft pencil, make sure it's soft, like this. I'm being quite scribbly, as you can see. I'm going to go in with my finger in a minute and blend it out. You can even do it around your faces. Sort of gives it its natural frame. A bit of glue around there. But look, when you smudge it in with your finger, I really like the look. And if it's not enough, you go back in with some more. The softer the pencil, the easier it is to smudge. So go in with your 6B or your 8B. I talked about a little bit of sanding as well. So if you use sandpaper on top of some of your stencil, chips off some bits as well, and I quite like that. Gives it more texture. Okay. So I just got to do the same with the frames. And it's still a bit gluey. So I might have to come back and do that a little bit more when it's dry. Just list your comments and I think the whole point of being a crafter is to be eternally broke. Definitely needs a little bit of drying time. There's some wet PVA here, but I hope that you're getting the gist of. You could do charcoal around the edges here as well, but I think charcoal might smudge again more. So, right, I'm going to pull the camera up because we're about done. Oh, get to see my ugly mug out. So, this is today's outcome. I'll see if I can show it you up close. Can you see those lovely faces? Old vintage faces. And it's double fold, because there's the old people. And it's really cool. And you've still got all that yummy paper showing through. And each page, I think, looks really nice in its own right. I just really love it. And anyone could do that. I've done that in an hour and it's been a bit of a rushed hour. But you could do that. There's no artistic license in that at all, other than putting three random colours together and choosing your images. And this lovely texture here. That is really cool. So next week we are probably going to be working on the box at the back, the secret box that we've created today that I've showed you. Oh, I'm glad you liked it, Louise. Yeah, so I'm going to be doing the secret box. So if any of you want to work alongside, I showed you how to prepare it at the beginning. This is still drying. This is actually quite a shallow box because I've actually used up quite a lot of my pages. But I showed you in the other book that I've prepared, showing you a little bit of the stage as well. So as you can see, our book is getting quite fat now. So, I hope you'll have a go. It's fun, isn't it? Isn't it fun? I just love just playing and coming up with something that's just really cool and colourful. Out of nothing, really. It's the Tim Holtz ideology paper, and one of the pages has got all the photographs on, but you could print them off. You could look up vintage pictures and print them off. You don't have to go and spend money. And the magazine is just any magazine. In fact, you could use torn up bits of this. It's just as fine. It's about strength, not necessarily colour, because you can put the colour on afterwards and you can put the texture on afterwards. So I use textured paste, but if you haven't got that, you can use grout stuff that you use to do tiling and stuff like that. You can use anything like that and it will still work. It just take a bit longer to dry, so just blast it with a hairdryer. Okay, don't let things like that get in the way. It's not always about having all the stuff. Okay, and I have used Jane Davenport crayons on this, but I could just as easily have used colouring pencils, pastels, or indeed my Fairy Chic chalk paint. It would have worked just as well. It's just, you know, personal preference today for the job in hand. But again, don't let that get in the way. Just have a go. thank you very much for sticking with me. I realise I've gone over, but I will be back next week to do the whole, you know, the hole in the book, the secret door. I'll have to find something secret and cool to put in it. I'll see you very, very soon. See you soon. Bye.